This video is created by Jagrat Creation. It is on dissolution of a partnership firm. I wish to solve one sum here before you. That is on dissolution of a partnership firm. And this question was asked by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India in IPCC exam. Observe the sum on the screen. A, B, C, D are sharing profits and losses in the ratio of 5:5:4:2. Frauds committed by C during the year were found out, and it was decided to dissolve the partnership firm on 31st October 2017 when their balance sheet was as under. On liability side, you are given the capital of A, B, C, D. General reserve, trade creditors, bills payable, building, stock, investment, debtors, cash. This is his capital debit balance. Following information is given to you. A check of 4,300 received from a debtor was not recorded in the books and was misappropriated by C. So one debtor has paid the firm 4,300. And this amount was misappropriated by C. Investment costing 5,400 were sold by C at rupees 7,900, and the funds transferred to his personal account. So investments of the partnership firm are sold, funds received are not deposited in the bank account of the firm, but the funds has been misappropriated and was transferred to the personal account of C. Creditor agreed to take over the investment at book value of 5,400 at rupees 8,400. So some of the investments are given to the creditors. And when the asset is given for payment of liability, you should not write the entry for such transaction if the asset to be realized is transferred to the debit side of realization account and the liability settled is also transferred to realization account at the time of dissolution accounting. So what I mean to say, if the asset to be realized is debited to realization account and liabilities to be settled is also credited to realization account, and in that situation, if the asset is given for payment of liability, no need to write the entry. I'll explain this concept once again while solving the sum. The rest of the creditors are paid at 2% discount. The other assets realized, building, 105% of book value, stock, investment, the rest of the investment were sold at a profit of 4,800. Debtors, the rest of the debtors were realized at a discount of 12%. Bills payable were settled at a discount of rupees 400. Expenses of dissolution amounted to 4,900. It was found that the realization from series private assets would be only rupees 4,000. Prepare necessary ledger accounts. This is a very nice sum. Just observe the style of solving the sum. For the purpose of solving this sum, I am going to prepare realization account, partners, capital account, cash account. Let me start with that and observe the manner in which I consider the adjustment and the details given in the balance sheet while solving the sum is an important point to be observed. So here I prepare. First of all, let me write down the profit sharing ratio because I am going to refer to it while solving the sum. Here I am going to prepare realization account, cash account, partners capital account. The partnership firm is dissolved. All the assets to be realized are transferred to the debit side of realization account. All the liabilities to be settled are credited to realization account. And they are transferred at a book value. So these are the book value of assets and liabilities. These are the information given to us. Now, first information is about debtors that I am going to consider simultaneously when I am going to consider debtors' information. So these are the assets to be realized. So building to be realized, transferred to the debit side of realization account. Stock debited to realization account. Investment 29,000. Now these 29,000 investments, as per the books of accounts, investments are 29,000. So what general students do, they transfer this investment 29,000 to the debit side of realization account. But here you are told that investment costing 5,400 were sold by C at rupees 7,900 and the funds transferred to his personal account. This sales was omitted from the firm's books. So investment to appear at 29,000, but partnership firm doesn't have really the investment of 29,000 to be transferred to realization account. So out of this 29,000 investment, the investment which are sold by C and already encashed cannot be transferred to realization account, because those investment which are already realized cannot be realized once again. So let me prepare a working note for the amount of investment to be transferred to realization account in light of this information given to me. Just observe, very important point. So this is the information about investment. It was found that the realization of C's private, okay, 4,000. So this is the information about investment is given to me. I prepare a working note. As per book value, I was having the investment of 29,000. Out of that, investment costing 5,400, book value 5,400, were sold by C. So this 5,400 investments are already realized. So it cannot be transferred to realization account. So from 29,000, 5,400 already realized are required to be deducted. So, and this 5,400 investment sold by C for rupees 7,900. So profit on sale of investment occurred 2,500 that was taken by C. So C is a receiver of this profit. At the same time, C is a receiver of investment costing 5,400. So cost of investment 5,400, which are taken by C, will be transferred to the capital account of C. The profit realized by C will be debited to C's capital account and will be recorded to the credit side of realization account, because we want to find out the profit to be distributed amongst partners at the instance of dissolution of a firm. So how this 5,400 and 2,000 profit will be recorded? 2,500 profit taken by C. So C is a receiver. So C is a capital account debit to realization account credit for profit, and C has taken the investment of 5,400. The book value of investment taken by C, means total encashment taken by C, is to be debited to C's capital account. So let me do that. 2,500 C's capital account debit to realization account credit. Now, the remaining investments, 23,600. The investment of book value 5,400 taken by C, so C's capital account debit to investment account credit. Now, this is how this information is considered. Now this investment left with me are going to be realized. So that will be debited to realization account. I can't debit 29,000 straightway to the debit side of realization account. So this 23,600 remaining investment debited to realization account. So this is an important point to be noticed. Out of the total investment book value 29,000, the investment realizable at the instance of dissolution is 23,600, and that has been debited to realization account. That's an important point to be understood. Now, a creditor agreed to take over the investment book value 5,400 at rupees 8,600. Now, investments are transferred to the debit side of realization account. The creditors are also going to be transferred to the credit side of realization account. And when the asset is given for payment of liability, you should not write the entry for that. But let me explain that by giving, creditors are given investment of 5,400. At a value of 8,400. So this asset given for payment of liability, the asset is already transferred to the debit side of realization account. Creditors are also going to be transferred to the credit side of realization account. So asset given for payment of liability, no entry. Why no entry? Because investments are here, creditors will be here. Now the realized value of investment will be recorded on the credit side, and the settled value of the liability will be recorded on the debit side. So when the asset is given for payment of liability, if the asset is transferred to realization account, book value of asset is already transferred to realization account, and the liabilities to be settled is also credited to realization account. The realized value of the asset will be credited and the settled value of liability will be debited. So if you want to write down the entry for this asset given for payment of liability, the entry to be recorded is realization account debit to realization account credit. And in such circumstances, it is advisable not to write the entry. So no entry. I'm not going to write down the entry, but as I have transferred the book value of investment to the debit side of realization account, I'm going to transfer the creditor's value to the credit side of realization account. So this no entry. Now, this is what is being done. Now the most important point that you should understand, these are the balance of investments. Now this balance of investments, see, the next important point, the rest of the creditors were paid at a discount of 2%. Now see, I have already transferred the book value of investment to the debit side of realization account. I am going to transfer the creditors' balance to the credit side of realization account. But which creditors, which are payable? These creditors are already paid, so 8,400 payment is already made. So what are the remaining creditors? So this creditors' book value, transfer to the credit side of realization account, out of which 8,400 has already been paid, and the rest of the creditors were paid at a discount of 2%. Remember once again, book value of investment debited to realization account, book value of creditors are credited to realization account, asset given for payment of liability. In that situation, the realized value will be recorded on the credit side, the payable settled value will be recorded on the debit side. So, asset given for payment of liability, journal entries, realization account, debit to realization account, credit. But I'm not going to write down the entry because assets and liabilities are already transferred to the realization account at its book value. Now, I'm required to write the payment for creditors. Now, total creditors are 47,000 out of that 8,400 has already been paid. So, these are the remaining creditors and they are paid at a discount of 2%. So, 38,600 into 2%, 772 is the discount. So, payment made to the creditors works out to be 37,822. For that, the entry will be recorded realization account debit to cash account credit. This is how settlement of creditors is being accounted for. Very important point. Total creditors 47,000. Out of that 8,400 settled by giving investment for that, no entries recorded. Remaining creditors are paid at 2% discount. The journal entry recorded for that is realization account debit to cash account. This is how creditor settlement is being accounted for. Now see, the investment. Rest of the investment were sold at a profit of 4,800. So these are the rest of the investment, 18,200. They are sold at a profit of 4,800. So add profit. So you will get the realized value of the remaining investment. So 23,000 rupees are received for the balance investment. And then the profit was occurred at 4,800. That will be taken care of automatically by crediting the sales value of the investment to the credit side of realization account. So for that, cash and bank account debit to realization account credit 23,000. So remaining investment realized 23,000. Remaining creditors are paid 37,822, 828. Asset given for payment of liability, no entry. Why? Because the total book value and the total settled book value of the liability was transferred to the debit and credit side of realization account respectively. So this is a very important working note that I have prepared. And in light of that, investment accounting, realization of investment is being recorded and the settlement of the liability towards the creditors is being accounted for. This is an important point. Now, after this investment is being done, next that I'm supposed to take care of is debtors. Debtors, for that you are given first item. A check of 4,300 received from debtor was not recorded in the books and was misappropriated by C. So what is the book value of the debtors? 42,000. How much debtors you are required to realize at the instance of dissolution? Total 42,000? No. Because already realized 4,300 are not going to be realized once again. So it should be removed therefrom. That's an important point. So here I prepare a working note. Debtors are 42,000. Already realized 4,300 debtors. A debtor of 4,300 received from a debtor was not recorded in the books and was misappropriated. So this 4,300 misappropriated by C will be transferred to the C's capital account. C is the receiver of the asset, debit the receiver. So C's capital account is to be debited for the debtors already realized by him. And the remaining debtors will be transferred to the debit side of realization account because they are going to be realized at the instance of dissolution of a partnership firm. So 4,300 already taken by C's capital account is debited. And the remaining debtors are debited to realization account. See, look at the style with which I copy the assets and liabilities in my realization account in light of the information given to you. And that's why this sum is very important. Now, debtors done. The rest of the debtors are realized at a discount of 12%. These are the rest of the debtors. 12% deducted therefrom. So, 4524 deducted therefrom. Cash received for debtors. Cash account debit to realization account credit. This is how debtor's point is being concluded. Now next, you are given cash balance that will be debited, recorded on the debit side on cash account. C's capital account debit balance is debited to C's capital account. Capital of A, B, C and D. C has got no balance. Debit balance is already recorded. So A, B, D capital credit balance is recorded in the respective capital account. Now, general reserve 24,000 will be distributed in the ratio of 5:5:4:2. So, general reserve distributed in the ratio of 5:5:4:2. So, 16. So, 5 by 16. 24,000 into 5 by 16. 24,000 into 5 by 16. 24,000 into 4 by 16. So, 6,000. And 2 by 16, 3,000. This is how general reserve is distributed amongst partners in the ratio of 5:5:4:2. And this ratio is applied to 24,000. Trade creditors are already considered. Bills payable liability transferred to the credit side of realization account. The bills payable were settled at a discount of 400. So 20,000 minus 400, this is the payment made for bills payable. Realization account debit to cash account credit. So, this is how balance sheet details are considered. Now, these assets are already transferred, realized, building realized 105% of the book value. So, 120,000 plus 5% thereon. So, 126,000 is realized value. Cash account debit to realization account credit. Same way. Stock realized 78,000, cash account debit to realization account credit. Now, just observe, have you realized all assets? Building stock done, investment debtors done, creditors bills payable paid, profit on sale of investment, this is being done. Now you are given the details of other adjustment expenses. Expenses of dissolution amounted to 4,900, realization account debit to cash account credit. It was found that the realization from C's private estate were 4,000. So amount that could be recovered from C, only 4,000. And the capital deficit of C will be distributed among solvent partners in the ratio of their capital. So this is the amount brought by C. Cash account debit to C's capital account credit. Now I want to close this realization account. But before that, let me work out the capital ratio. So A, B, C, D, this is the capital of A, 97,500, C is insolvent, so D's capital is 38,000, amount on the debit side is zero. So this is the capital balance existed at the time of dissolution of a partnership firm. So capital deficit is going to be distributed in this ratio. So capital ratio is being worked out. Now let me find out the realization profit or loss. So total of credit minus total of debit. So this is the realization profit that will be distributed in the ratio of 5:5:4:2. So this is the 5:16. 4:16. This is how it is being recorded. So realization account debit to partners, capital account credit. The realization profit distributed amongst partners. Now I am required to work out the capital deficit of C and that will be distributed among solvent partners is the ratio of capital that has already been worked out, just observe that I do. So total of debit of capital C. So total of debits at 27,200. Credits at 10,137. So this is the capital deficit. Distributed between A, B and D. The capital deficit is distributed between A, B and D in the ratio of capital. So 975 to 975 to 380. So fixed capital ratio. So 17,063 into 975 divided by 2,330. So this is the share of A in capital deficit. Same is the share of B in capital deficit. And C's share is 380 divided by 2,330. 2,783 is the share of C in the capital deficit. This capital deficit to be borne by solvent partners will be debited to the capital account of solvent partners, and the insolvent part of capital account is to be credited for this capital deficit that is being transferred to the capital account of solvent partners. Let me do that. A's account debit, C's account credit, B's account debit, C's account credit, D's account debit, C's account credit. This is how C's capital account gets closed. Now I'm required to close the capital account of A, B and D. Their capital dues are to be paid. Now let me do that. So total of credits at 97671 minus 7140. This is the amount to be paid to A. Is capital account debit to cash account? Same way I should work out for B. 97671 minus 7140. So this is the amount to be paid to B. B's capital account debit to cash account. And so far as D is concerned, total of credit side is 38,069. I write 38,069 over here, and from there I did a 2783, and this is the amount payable to D. So this capital account debit to cash account credit. This is how payment is made against partner's capital on dissolution of a partnership firm. Now have a total of cash account debit and credit. The totals of both the sides should agree. Total of debit side is 2,78,676, and same is the total for credit side of cash account. This is how cash account agreement takes place. The agreement of cash account ensures that we are right for accounting of dissolution. So this is an important sum wherein the misappropriation made by C is being taken care of, and how the accounting for dissolution of a partnership firm is made. I have tried to explain you this sum. I feel that you have followed all these things. Thanks to Allah.